Hello YouTube, and this is going to be my quick overview of the Lenovo Y410P. And I have it in my backpack to show that it can fit. It's portable. This is it. Lenovo Y410P. I'm going to flip it over and get view of the bottom. This is the exhaust vent for ventilation. It's got another on the left. Okay. I'm gonna set it down over here. This Y410P is the one with an i7 processor, 4th generation Haswell. It's got 8 gigabytes of DDR3 RAM, 1 terabyte hard drive. That's a 5400 RPM hard drive, and a 24 gigabyte SSD with a 14-inch high-definition LED with 1600 by 900 resolution. So I believe there's 4 options on their website. This will be the 3rd one. The 4th option includes a Blu-ray. But anyways, I'm gonna do a quick, aesthetic view of the laptop. Get some lighting here with the lamp. People who care about the aesthetics can get a good look of it. Okay, so I'm gonna do just a quick overview. Sorry about the shaking, but it's my phone. So, anyways, I'm gonna do a quick pros and cons. Well, let me open it real quick so you can see. So here's the inside view. As you can tell, it picks up fingerprints quite easily. It's got a touchpad, is non-button touchpad, which is okay for word processing and surfing the web. It's not really good for gaming, but if you're gonna game, you're probably gonna have your own separate mouse. The keyboard's quite nice. Despite some people on YouTube say it's not great, I think it's good for most people. It would be fine. And here, let me just show you that it has a backlit keyboard. Let me turn this light off. Low, high, off. Okay, turn this back on. I'll log in. So, most people are gonna want to know what this laptop's good for. Well, it's pretty much good for everything. Anyone who wants a multimedia laptop, this is perfect. It can do word processing, it can do, surf the web like nothing, and it can do some pretty decent gaming. The pros: the performance is good. The performance to price ratio is really good, actually. And this is the main reason why most people are gonna choose this laptop. But yeah, that's the main pro of the system, I would say. And the aesthetics are not too bad. I mean, it does, as you can tell, it does pick up fingerprints. It does, oily fingers will be apparent. But, man, there's not much you can do about it. And then, as you can see, that big bezel on the screen, they could have easily have made this a 15-inch form factor with this, with that room. Just a, kind of wasted space. But, I mean, other than that, I mean, it does look sleek, and it's kind of stealth. I mean, it's not too gamer looking. It's just you know, you can, it's good. And the resolution on the screen is perfect for 14 inch, I think. I mean, it would be nice if they, you know, offered an 8 full 1080 picture display, but I mean, for this screen size, 1600 by 900 is fine. And the weight is not too bad. It's just under 5 pounds. And the backlit keyboard's a plus. And overall, it's a pretty good computer. It's well featured. Now I'm gonna briefly talk about the cons. Well, I mean, besides, I already mentioned the bezel. Also, the battery life isn't great, but it's okay. You can get about a little over 4 hours with the screen brightness down and the Wi-Fi off. With the Wi-Fi on, with the Wi-Fi on, with about 60% brightness, you can get about a little over 3 hours, up to 3.5 hours, I think. And then that would be in power saving mode. And then in balance mode, you get a little bit more performance. And with the brightness almost all the way up, you can get about maybe 3 to 2.5 hours. So you can watch a movie, one movie. But so the battery life is decent, but not great. Wi-Fi, another thing is the Wi-Fi. That's another con. When it first arrived, I was having issues with it. The Wi-Fi card was acting strange. I did a little bit of research, and it looks like the Intel Wireless N2230 chip that's in this laptop and many other laptops are having similar issues. So what would happen is the internet, for some inexplicable reason, would just disconnect. And the router is right there, so, like, you know, it shouldn't be doing that. I mean, the router. Anyways, after, you know, trying for countless hours, I finally decided, you know what, I'm gonna go to the Intel website and update the driver. And after I updated the driver, I haven't had any issues since. So if you, anybody else who buys this and you're having some connectivity issues, try updating the driver and see if that helps. But ever since I did that, whether it be 5 feet or 40 feet away from the wireless router, it's been just fine, no issues. So yeah, that's kind of a con, because, you know, out of the box, it should be good to go. You shouldn't have to mess with things like that. And then the build quality would be another con. It's mostly plastic, and I mean, the screen piece is pretty solid, but the bottom piece where the keyboard and the computer's at, where the motherboard's at, is a multi-piece. It's multi-piece, like 3 pieces. So if you drop this, I mean, not that it's intended to be dropped, but let's say you did drop it on accident, yeah, it probably would do some serious damage. I mean, but other than that, it's not flimsy, you know, it's just not made out of aluminum or, you know, some exotic metal. So, and my last con will be Windows 8. Windows 8 is just not great for people who want to use it for, you know, serious things. Plus, this doesn't even come with a touchscreen, so, you know, it kind of defeats the purpose of having Windows 8. So, anyways, let me just log in real quick here so I can show you how I have it set up. As you can tell, I have a start bar, and it doesn't look much like Windows. Doesn't look much like Windows 8. That's because There are some workarounds for, you know, for people who don't like Windows 8. And unfortunately, since you don't have much of a choice with this system, there's some software you can download that will, you know, make Windows 8 more like Windows 7. So you get your classic search bar and all that. And Windows 8 is kind of a con, but I mean, there are some workarounds. So overall, if I were to rate this thing, I would give it like an 8 out of 10. It's not the best laptop out there, but it's definitely not the worst one out there. And it's the main selling point for this laptop, or the main reason to buy this, is you're getting a lot of bang for your buck. I mean, that the NVIDIA GT750M is one of the highlights of this system, and it can handle games pretty well. To note, make sure you put it in performance mode when you do run intensive hardware intensive applications. And speaking of hardware intensive applications, another thing to note is the exhaust right here, it can get quite hot. So if you are playing a game or something, and you're moving your character or whatever, and then you decide, oh, I'm gonna put my hand here, the rest, oh, you're gonna burn yourself. So I mean, it's not a big deal. I mean, the good thing is the keyboard doesn't get hot itself. It's just this edge here, and then it'll blow really hot air. I mean, that's kind of a love hate thing, because you know it's good that the ventilation system is, you know, the cooling system in this laptop is doing its job by throwing the hot air out of it. But at the same time, you know, it would have probably been better if the exhaust was, you know, vented out through the back or something. But anyways, it's not a big deal. For some people, that might be a big deal, but I mean, it's not really a big deal. It just means that your laptop, you know, cooling system is doing what it's supposed to be doing, getting rid of hot air. Anyways, this will conclude my brief overview of the Lenovo White 410P. If anybody has any questions regarding it, please feel free to ask, and I'll be happy to answer any questions.